Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to learn about passing of arrays to a function in C language. Okay, so in the previous videos, we have discussed about the functions. Okay, so in the functions, we have discussed about the elements of functions, categories of functions, and return function, recursion, like that. So we have discussed different features of the functions. So in the elements of functions, we are having the function call, function declaration, and function definition. Okay, so in the function call, we are going to pass the actual parameters to the function definition in the to the formal parameters in the function definition, right? So here we are only passing the parameters, that is actual parameters to the formal parameters, okay, or actual arguments to the formal arguments. But here, instead of passing the arguments, we are passing the arrays to a function in the C language. Okay, so here the passing of array to a function in C language is done in two types. So the declaration is done in two ways. That is, passing an array as a parameter and passing the pointer as a parameter. Okay, so like this, in this two way, we can pass the parameters. Okay. So here in the passing of array as a parameter, so we have taken the data type followed by the function name, and here in the arguments we are going to define the array name. So we have taken the array name and the type of the array, whether it is integer, float, or char, like that we have defined, and pointers as a parameter. So we are taking the data type of the function and function followed by the pointer name and its type. So we will discuss about the pointers as parameter in the next upcoming videos. So now let us discuss about the arrays as a parameter. So passing the arrays as a parameter to a function. Okay, so the passing of arrays to a function is done in three ways, that is passing individual array elements, passing arrays to the functions, and passing two-dimensional arrays. So in these three ways we can pass the arrays to a function. Okay, so now let us see the first one, that is the passing individual array elements. So in passing individual array elements, okay, so we are going to see the see some example here. Okay, so here given the main function followed by the age. So age is 2, 8, 4, 12. So we have as age, and here I am copying the age of 4 persons to the age array, and here I am calling a function display. Okay, so I want to display the individual elements in the array, that is with the subscript 1 and the subscript 2. Okay, so when this function is invoked, then the control will pass to the the definition, function definition. Okay, so here it will pass, and the values in the actual parameters is copied to the formal parameters, and it will get displayed here in the using the printf. Okay, so here we are passing the arrays as arguments instead of the parameters. So how this array will be created? So 2, 8, 4, and so here when this function is called, then the control automatically pass to the calling function. Okay, so here I want to display the person's age in the subscript 1 and subscript 2. So here in the subscript 1, 8 is there, and subscript 2, 4 is there. Okay, so then these values will be copied to the formal parameters, and it will be displayed here in the printf age 1, that is 8, age 2 is 4. It will get printed on the output screen. Okay, so in passing the array elements, we are going to pass the address of the particular individual element here. Okay, so here if you see the output, so it will display the values 8 and 4. So next one is the passing arrays to a function. We are going to pass a array. So array, normal array is a one-dimensional array I am taking. So I am going to pass the one-dimensional array as a argument to the calling the function definition. So here, so given the main function, okay, so in the main function I want to display the average of the student marks. Okay, I'm taking the marks here, okay, int marks with 7 subject marks I'm taking, and I want to perform the average of the marks. Okay, so here average of marks is the function. Okay, so when this function gets invoked, then the control will pass to the average of marks. Okay, average of int marks. Okay, so here since the average is of the float type, so float average of int marks I'm taking, and then so I'm going to display the marks here. Okay, present in the array. So normally in the one dimensional array, I'm going to pass the base address here. So I'm going to pass the base address of this particular array. Okay, so here if you are going to have this array in the array format, so that is 99 90 and 96, and so on, we are having the different array elements, right? So if you are going to if you want to pass this array elements, so I'm going to pass the base address here. Okay, so base address of the marks. So what is the base address? So here the base address will be 100 I'm taking. So I'm passing the base address, that is the starting of the array address. So it will be passed as a actual argument to the function definition. So when this is passed to the function definition, then using the for loop, I am going to display all the elements in the array. Okay, so for I equals to 0, I less than equals to 6. So I equals to 0, so this is the first subscript, right? 0, 1 and 2. So I is equal to 0, so I am going to print the sum equals to sum plus marks of I. So in index I, that is 0, so marks of 99. Plus 90 plus 96 plus 93, 98, 89 and 82. Okay, so here I am going to perform the sum, that is 0 plus the marks of all the student marks, all the 7 subjects, and then I am going to perform the average equals to sum by 5 and return the average for the average of all the marks to the calling function. Okay, so here the everything is same. Instead of passing the arguments, we are passing the base address of the array to the function definition. Okay, so here we can see the average marks equals to 131.0 as the output. Okay, so next one is passing the multi-dimensional arrays to the functions. So here we can pass two-dimensional arrays. I am taking the two-dimensional arrays here to a function. Okay, so here also simply we are passing the base address of the two dimensional array. So here I am taking, first of all I am declaring the function display numbers with the two dimensional array number of 2, 2. Okay, so here I am taking four numbers, enter four numbers. So I am entering the it is taking the four numbers from the user as input, and it is displaying that four numbers which are taken as input from the user on the output screen. Okay, so here enter four numbers. So it is using the for loop, we are going to take the input of the two dimensional array as from the user. Okay, and when this function is called, then the control will automatically pass to the function definition and it will display the values. So here it is taking the input from the user and it is displaying the same input from the user as a output on the screen. Okay, so when this so here number of iz, so here is, since it is a two-dimensional array, so it is going to pass the base address of this particular two-dimensional array to the called function. Okay, so it will display all the numbers in the given two-dimensional array with the index here ij. So here the output will be in this format. Okay, we are entering the four numbers here, so 2, 4, 5, 6, and displaying the given numbers. Okay. So like this, we are going to take the input from the user. Okay, in the first part. Okay, and then we are going to print the same numbers which is taken from the user in this format. Okay. So this is about the passing two-dimensional arrays to the function. So this is the passing of arrays to a function. It may be any array, like it may one-dimensional, two-dimensional, three-dimensional, or any individual array element. We are going to pass the address of the particular array element or the base address of the array to the function definition. Okay. So this is all about the passing arrays to a function in C. Thanks for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.